Two presentations. So there is a PPT on Screencast-O-Matic. So instructions are available there. By the way, all my presentations are downloadable and you can reuse. So if you open this, these are all the instructions. This is all my presentations are OneDrive, so you can embed if your presentations are on this. Do you know what's the advantage of using Screencast-O-Matic? Or let me quickly take you through this PPT. Do you know? Can I skip this? You know now? You don't know? Yeah. So this, I think PPT is available on my course page. You can go through after this session also. You can create, share screen recordings. So now you have free version. We have 15-minute time limit is there, but never create a video or capture a video more than 5 minutes. Ideally, it should be less than 4 minutes. Student attention span is not that so long. It will allow us to, after recording, it will allow us to either upload to YouTube, or you can save it as a video file, or you can directly upload to Screencast-O-Matic. So these are free features and pro features. Anyway, your university now, they are going to subscribe 150 licenses for you. Advantage is no watermark. Editing tools are there. So it will make your job easier when compared to using this free version. You can record script, you can download your script and record first your audio, then you can edit, then you can run your PPTs. All those features are there. If somewhere you find some voice is breaking or something, so in that part you can again re-record. So all these features are available in this pro features. Pro version, okay. You can publish to YouTube, upload to Google Drive or Dropbox, all these are there. Yeah, as I said, scripted recording and so many overlays are available. You can highlight some part of your text. If you are demonstrating a software, you can highlight. So, advantage of going for this pro version, these all are the advantages. So, please, all of you go to screencast-o-matic.com and click on Launch Recorder. We'll do that. This PPT is available on my course page, Moodle Enabled Blended Learning. From there also you can directly click the link and I'll show you. I'll do one thing. So, I'm demonstrating here. So, I'm clicking on screencast-o-matic.com. You click on start recording for free. Then one more button is there, launch recorder. Are you in the same screen, all of you? Are you in sync with me? Okay, click on launch free recorder. It will download that application. You just run that application. You already have a licensed version. Let me check what will happen. Download should start in second. So once it's been downloaded, bottom of your screen you will find this web launch recorder exe file. You just need to double click on that. That's it. Or open that or so once you click on this, it says starting up. So this is how you also get. Who is ready with a PPT? Anyone of you ready with a PPT? Yeah, please, you come and record, get that. You have a pen drive? Okay. Yeah, you please download and we will record that. So, similar way, you should also have all these dotted lines. You can resize the frame or else, yeah, just go to the preferences and size. Where is that? Here. Yeah, go to preferences and then, you are already there. Cancel. Not preferences. So, this is the, go to size and pick up the full screen. Okay, done, or again change that and redemonstrate. Okay, you change the size to full screen so that your entire screen will be captured. Done, shall we proceed? Okay, now you go to slideshow. Yeah, we have three options. Yeah, you please sit down. So that we have three options, that is full screen, only your face, click on webcam, so only your face, but we prefer both. So either here, you can drag it anywhere. Okay. Okay, are you ready with this dual mode, that is last one, both? Are you ready with your face as well as with your presentation? Then click on the slideshow. You run the slideshow, then we will start recording. Where is that? No, you should come out of this presenter mode, then only. You click on this. Yeah, slideshow and come out of the presenter mode. Wait. Here you have this presenter mode. Where is that? You get all these three dotted lines. Where is hide presenter view? Even then you are not getting this. Many we have present. We lost this again. You press on this. Duplicate this. No, not okay. Again, yeah. It's not working. Okay. Yes. Now you click on this presentation. Never mind, it's not here very good.
We're going to capture this part.
No, we want both now. Close this, what happened? It's not working. Then it's not visible here. Okay, it's there. Now you click on record. So you'll get this countdown timer. Am I? It's not visible here. Okay, you start narrating. You can start narrating. Yes, narrating and use these buttons for slides.
Good afternoon, everybody. We are now in the workshop on Moodle enabled blended learning organized by Sadeep Ambalacharan, UMS. And this is a 5-day workshop, which is actually facilitated by Dr. Indira. from India. So now I'm going to introduce myself. I'm Instagram and Chaudhary. I'm the lecturer in International Business and Business
Open your PPT, then click on record.
Based on my academic background, now I am pursuing my PhD on international business. Before that, in 2002, I have completed my Master of International Business from University of Wollongong, Australia. I did graduate diploma in business communication from Wollongong University College in Australia in 2001. Before that, I have completed my Bachelor of Business Administration in International Business from State University, Bangladesh. At the same time, recently I have published my first book on for undergraduate students in Malaysia. In the
last one. Now, browse folder. It will take us to the folder. Yeah, that is the video. Now come back to your YouTube browser. Right top you have this video icon. Click on that video. And click on upload video. Now you first, before uploading, change this public to unlisted. Public to unlisted, never use the last one, that is private. If you share this link, your student will not be able to see. So the second option is you just pull it down. By default, it will show us this public, unlisted, private. Use the second option. So it's not open for public, they cannot search using any keyboard. It will not be published until unless you click on this. Now you can either click on the arrow or drag and drop if you are comfortable with your mouse. So here you add your description, that's the video, course introductory, so and so. You can add tags. The advantage of tags is if it is a public video, similar way we search using keywords. It improves discoverability of your video. So this is a video URL. After once, wait.
Yeah.
It's still processing. Once you are done with the processing 100%, then you can click on that. Creative Commons. If you want to add Creative Commons, go to Advanced Settings.
Right now.
And change these settings we can.
Okay.
And change this license from standard YouTube license to, by default, it takes a standard YouTube license. If you want to open this for public, in that scenario, you should choose the first option, that is public, then you choose this. So, I'll demonstrate how to search for a Creative Commons license videos on YouTube. So, you can change this to Creative Commons, then publish. Now, your video is ready. Are you ready with your video? At least? Dummy video, I mean not high quality video. Please, all of you complete this. I'll show you how to embed this video on your course page. All of you should get this